So now, let's look at what revenue the tax will produce and what effect the tax will have on overall economic welfare. And of course, buyers are going to be made worse off by the tax because the effective price they're paying is going up, so they have lower consumer surplus. Sellers are receiving, net of tax, a lower price, and so they're going to have lower producer surplus. But then again, the government gains some tax revenue, and total tax revenue is going to equal the size of the tax per unit times the quantity transacted. And remember, of course, that the tax is going to reduce the quantity transacted somewhat. Graphically, we can see that tax revenue is going to be this box here, where the width of the box is equal to the quantity transacted with the tax, and the height of the box is equal to the tax per transaction. Here's a little review question that you can go ahead and assess yourself on. And then notice that when we do this, when we start to model overall economic welfare, I think it's not very controversial to measure taxes as a cost. Most people don't like taxes, although they may accept that taxes are necessary to fund government services and spending. But then the question arises how to actually value that government spending. And of course, people get to have very different opinions on this. Some people will think that money spent to increase the capabilities of the U.S. military is well spent, and some people will think that it's really, you know, very, very badly spent. Likewise, if money is spent to help people who are unemployed, some people might think, well, you know, that's money well spent. Other people might think, you know, we shouldn't be encouraging people to, you know, not go out and search really hard for jobs. So because of all that, we're going to go ahead and basically just punt on this idea of value in government spending, and instead just notice that $1 of tax revenue funds $1 of spending. And no matter what, pretty much, that $1 of spending is income for someone, and they would value it at $1. So we're going to treat each dollar of tax revenue as giving $1 of benefit. That said, what can we say about how a tax affects economic welfare? Without the tax, of course, the equilibrium price would be here at P1. Consumer surplus would be everything above P1 and below the demand curve. So consumer surplus would be A plus B plus C. Producer surplus, without the tax, would be everything below the price and above the supply curve. So producer surplus would be D plus E plus F. When we have the tax, buyers pay an effective price up here of P sub B. So once we have the tax in place, consumer surplus is this smaller triangle A, which is above P sub B and below the demand curve. Producer surplus is everything below P sub S and above the supply curve. B and D are equal to the amount of the tax times the number of transactions. So B plus D is overall government revenue. And then C and E, very much like our price ceilings and price floors, C and E is our deadweight loss. Because what happens here is transactions have been reduced from Q1 to Q2. And these transactions between Q1 and Q2 were mutually beneficial. But they weren't mutually beneficial enough to justify going through with them once the tax was in place. Because remember, the mutual benefit from a transaction is equal to willingness to pay minus seller cost. So all these transactions between Q2 and Q1 generated less gains from trade than the amount of the tax, and therefore people don't find it worthwhile to go through with them after the tax has been established. If we drop a little ledger here of the economic welfare, we can track the changes, and once we go through with all that, we can see that although B and C are lost from consumer surplus, B at least shows up as tax revenue, whereas C does not. So C is deadweight loss, the change in total surplus. The negative change in total surplus is deadweight loss. D and E are lost from producer surplus, but at least D shows up as tax revenue, while E is part of deadweight loss. And this brings up a somewhat subtle, perhaps even counterintuitive point. The taxes that you actually pay are the good part of taxes, because the purpose of taxes is to raise revenue. The really bad part of taxes is the deadweight loss, is the transactions that were discouraged by the taxation, and the decrease in economic efficiency that occurred because of the taxation.